Hello my dear students, how are you? Hope that you all are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Your evaluation test has been finished some days ago, but you can't take rest now because your test examination is knocking at the door. I think you are taking a great preparation for your ensuing test examination. According to the lesson plan, today my topic is transformation of sentence. You all know transformation of sentence is a big syllabus for you. There are so many rules in this topic. But as you are the students of class 10, I think you have already got a clear idea about transformation of sentence. Today, I will discuss about two rules just to remind you. One is though or although, and the another is if. I think this class will be very helpful to you. Okay, let's start the class. Look at the board. At first, look at the example. Though he is this, he is unhappy. At first, you decide which sentence is this sentence. Is it simple sentence? Is it complex sentence? Or is it compound sentence? As we know, if a sentence starts with though or although, it is called complex sentence. You also know that a complex sentence has two clauses. One is subordinate clause and another is principal clause. So look at the example. Though he is rich, he is unhappy. This sentence starts with though. Again, it has two clauses. One clause is he is rich, it is subordinate clause, and another is he is unhappy, it is principal clause. So this sentence is complex sentence. Now we will convert this complex sentence to simple sentence. In order to convert this sentence to simple sentence, we have to follow a rule. So what is the rule? I have written it in the whiteboard. At first, we will write in spite of or despite of. Then we will write possessive form of subject. Then we will write verb 1 plus ing. Then we will write the rest of the sentence. Okay. Now I am writing this sentence according to the rule. At first, I will write in spite of or despite, instead of though or although. We can't write though or although in a simple sentence because though or although is only for complex sentence. Instead of though or although, we will write in spite of or despite. In spite of or despite. So what have I written in spite of? Then I will write possessive form of subject. Which word is subject here? He is subject. So what is the positive form of he? The positive form of he is his. then we will write var 1 plus ing. Here var is. If we add ing to is, then it if we add ing to is, we have to write be. Then we will write the rest of the sentence. Now I will convert this complex sentence to simple sentence following this rule. At first, I will write in spite of or despite, in instead of, though or although. In spite of. Then I will write possessive form. Possessive form. Here subject is he. So what is the positive form of he? The positive form of he is his. Then I will write verb 1 plus ing. Which word is verb here? Is. If we add ing to is, we will write being. B-E-I-N-G, being. Then I will write this. And second course. So what is the answer of this sentence? The question is, though he is rich, he is unhappy. The answer of this sentence is, in spite of his being rich, he is unhappy. Now we will convert this sentence to compound sentence. What is the rule of compound sentence? Actually, it is very easy rule. Only we will write but or yet in place of comma. Look, at first we have to write subject. Which word is subject here? He. Then I will write her. Is. Then this. Then I will write but or yet in place of comma. Then I will write second clause. He is unhappy. Okay. I am repeating it again. If we want to convert this complex sentence to compound sentence, we will convert it following this rule. According to the rule, at first we will write subject. Here he is subject. So I have written he. Then verb. Here verb is. So I have written is. Then is. Then I will write but or yet in the place of commas, but or yet. You can write anyone, but, and then I will write second clause. He is unhappy. I think you have understood these three examples. Now I am giving you another example. Okay, students. I have written here another example. What's the example? Look at the board. Though she was poor, she bought a car. It is also complex sentence because this sentence has started with do. Okay. For converting this complex sentence to simple sentence, at first, what will we write? We will write in spite of or despite. In spite of. Then we will write positive form of subject. Subject here is she, so positive form is her. Then we will write verb 1 plus ing. Here verb is was. If we add ing to it, we will write be. Then I will write the rest of the sentence. Now I will convert this sentence to compound sentence. So look at the rule. At first I will write subject. Here subject is she. Then I will write her, was. Then I will write were. Then I will write but or yet in place of commas. But you can write yet, no problem. Then I will write the main words. She bought a car. I think you have understood these examples. I am again repeating this rule. If a sentence starts with though or although, it is called complex sentence. In order to convert it to simple sentence, at first we have to write in spite of or despite. Then we will write positive form of subject. Then we will write verb 1 plus ing and then the rest of the sentence. In the same way, again, when we want to convert it to compound sentence, at first we have to write subject, then we will write her, then the rest word, then we will write but or yet in place of commas, and then we will write the second clause or the main clause. You have to memorize this rule. If you memorize this rule, it will be better for you, and you can convert any sentence. Okay, here is another example. Look at the example. In spite of his being kind, nobody likes him. At first, you decide which sentence is this sentence. This sentence starts with in spite of. We know if a sentence starts with in spite of, it is called simple sentence. So it is a simple sentence. We will convert it to complex sentence by following this rule. At first, what will we write? We will write though or although in instead of in spite of. We will not write in spite of. Rather, we will write though or although. Though. Then we will write subject. Here, his is positive form. We will write subjective form of his. So what is the subjective form of his? He. then we will write har man or har to. That means finite man. Here being is not finite har. Being means am, is, are, was, were. So which verb will we write here? Will we write here am or is or are or was or were? It will totally depend on the verb of main clause. The verb of main clause here is verb 1. The verb of main clause is verb 1. If the verb of main clause is verb 1, then we will write am, is, are in lieu of being. Here subject is he, singular form. So we will write is. We cannot write here was, because here lies is verb 1. If then I will write the rest of the sentence. I think you have understood this sentence. Now I will convert it to compound sentence. So at first, what will I write? I will write at first subject. Here, in this clause, there is no subject, but there is a possessive form. We have to write subject of this possessive form. Here possessive form is his. So the subjective form of his is he. Then we will write her. Here be, we will write is. As likes is her one, so we have written here is. Then I will write mind, and then I will write but or yet in place of commas. Then I will write the rest of the sentence or the main clause. Look, at first we have to write subject. I have written subject he, then I have written his, her, then kind, then I have written but or yet in the place of comma. Actually, I have written yet or but in lieu of, in spite of, and then I have written the main clause. I think you have understood this sentence. Okay. Okay, students. Now I will discuss about another rule, and that is if. Look at the example. If you read more, you will learn more. If a sentence starts with if, it is called complex sentence. And again, this sentence has two clauses. One is subordinate clause and another is main clause. So, if we want to convert this sentence to simple sentence, we have to follow this rule. What is the rule? At first, we have to write by. Then we have to write verb 1 plus ing. And then we will write the rest of the sentence. Students, now I will convert this sentence to simple sentence by following this rule. So at first I आई विल राइट भार वन प्लस आईएनजी या भार इज रीड सो आई हैव टू राइट रीडिंग देन आई विल राइट द रेस्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस Again, I am repeating this. At first, I have to write by. Then, I have to add ing with var. If I add ing with read, it will be reading. Then, I will write the rest of the sentence. I will not write the him or you. So, to convert this sentence, to compound sentence, at first I will write var 1. Which word is var here? Read. So at first I will write read. Then more. Then I will write and in place of commas. And then I will write the main clause. I think you have understood this. Okay, I am repeating it again. To convert a complex sentence to compound sentence, at first we have to write var 1. Which word is var here? Read. I have written read. Then I have written more. Then comes the vital word. Comma. I must write and in place of commas and then I will write the rest of the sentence. You will learn. I think you have understood this. I have written here another example for you. By taking physical exercise, you will be fit. It is a simple sentence because this sentence starts with by plus var 1 plus ing. We know that if a sentence starts with by plus var 1 plus ing, it is called simple sentence. In order to convert it to complex sentence, we have to follow the rule of the complex sentence. So, at first, we will write if. Then we will write subject you. Then we will write var. Taking, we will write take. Then we will write the rest of the sentence. To convert this sentence to compound sentence, we have to follow the rule of compound sentence. So at first we have to write var 1. Here var is taking. We will write take. Then we will write physical exercise. Then we will write and in place of commas. And then we will write the rest of the sentence of the main clause. I am repeating again this. If a sentence starts with by plus var 1 plus ing, it is called simple sentence. In order to convert this simple sentence to complex sentence, at first we will write if, then we will write subject. In this clause, there is no subject. You will find subject in the main clause. The subject here is you. So, I have written here you. Then, we have to write var 1 or var 2. Here, var is taking. I have written take. Then, I will write the rest of the sentence. And in order to convert this sentence to compound sentence, at first we have to write verb 1. Here verb is taking. We will not write taking, we will write take. Then we will write physical exercise. And then we will write and in place of comma. And then we will write the main clause. You will be fit. Students, I think you have understood this example, these examples. Now, I am giving you another example. Okay, look at the example. Work hard and you will prosper. At first decide which sentence is this sentence. And this is compound sentence. This is compound sentence. So to convert this sentence to complex sentence, at first we will write it. Then we will write subject. In this clause, there is no subject. We will find subject in the main clause. So subject here is you. So I will write here you. Then I will write verb. Work. Here verb is work. Hard. I will pick up and. And you will prosper. I am repeating this again. To convert this sentence to complex sentence, at first we have to write if. So I have written here if. Then we have to write subject. Here is no subject. Subject is in the main clause. So I have written subject. From the main clause, you, then I will write verb. Here verb is work. Then I have written hard. Now, I cannot write here and, because and is only for compound sentence. We will write comma instead of and. Then we will write the rest of the sentence. I think there is no problem in this sentence. Then I will convert it to simple sentence. At first I will write by. Then I will write verb 1 plus ing. Here verb is work. I have to add ing with work. Then I will write hard. I will not write here and, rather I will write comma. And then I will go. Okay students, hope you have understood today's lesson very well. In my next class, I will discuss another rule. Until then, stay well, stay healthy, and of course, stay at home. Goodbye.